Good evening, viewers. This is Bhavna Vijayan for Red Spot News. Headlines. Dead in fire at luggage factory in Delhi. Short circuit suspected. Major security lapses identified in the factory. Delhi government declares judicial inquiry. One should never denigrate India. Vice President's reply to Rahul Gandhi's remark over rape capital. Karivattam to host India-West Indies T20 series. Sanju Samson will play or not is what fans are waiting for. News in detail. 43 people lost their lives in a massive fire broke out in Delhi's Anish Mandi on Rani Jhansi Road. The factory did not have any safety measures and NOC. Judicial inquiry ordered over the matter. Our reporter Kesia is joining us with the updates. Kesia, take us through the updates.
Bhavna, the Delhi chief now told that the factory where the fire took place, it's a six-story building. It did not have any approval from the Delhi Fire Service, neither was any safety equipments in the premises. That's what the Delhi Fire Service found out when they went to rescue the people who were trapped inside the building in a factory of smoke. The owner of the building did not comply with any rules. Now the Delhi government has ordered a judicial inquiry into the matter, Bhavna.
That was Kesia with the updates. Moving on. Job assured for Unnao rape victim's sister after she refused to cremate the victim's body. The family refused to do the last rites until Chief Minister Adityanath visited them and assured them their demands.
Demands raised by Unnao rape victim's family finally accepted by the Uttar Pradesh administration. The move came soon after the victim's sister refused to cremate the body unless Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath meet the family. The administration has agreed to meet all her demands and also put the case in fast trial court. Lucknow Divisional Commissioner Mukesh Mishram has ensured that the sister will be given 24-hour security and her brother will be given a license as per Arms Act. News Desk, Red Spot News.
Vice President Venkaiah Naidu in a series of tweets said that we must never denigrate India. He was replying to Rahul Gandhi's statement, which Mr. Gandhi made on Saturday, that India is becoming the rape capital of world.
The Vice President was replying to Rahul Gandhi's statement in a series of tweets by not mentioning his name. In his tweet, Naidu wrote, "Somebody said India is becoming capital of so-and-so. We should never denigrate our country." While addressing a function at Pune Symbiosis University, he also said that bringing new laws is no solution. They had brought a new bill on Nirbhaya but asked if anything has changed in the country. He was referring to the recent incidents on crimes against women. News Desk, Red Spot.
Greenfield Stadium in Thiruvananthapuram to witness the second match of India-West Indies T20 series. The match will begin at 7 in the evening. The first match between India and West Indies took place on Friday in Hyderabad. The Indian team is fully confident for today's match after the win in Hyderabad. At the same time, will Sanju Samson be playing for today's match, which is happening in his hometown, is what fans are eagerly waiting for. Headlines once again. dead in fire at luggage factory in Delhi. Short circuit suspected. Major security lapses identified in the factory. Delhi government declares judicial inquiry. One should never denigrate India. Vice President's reply to Rahul Gandhi's remark over rape capital. Karivattam to host India-West Indies T20 series. Sanju Samson will play or not is what fans are waiting for. And with that, that's a wrap from me on this edition of Red Spot News. Thanks for watching.
You are watching Red Spot News.